the BJP party chief Amit Shah, with the Prime Minister sitting by his side, gave a strong defense of this government in the past 5 years and predicted that the BJP will be re-elected with a full majority. In fact, what Amit Shah actually said is that the BJP will win a majority. We will win over 300 seats. The government will be formed on the basis of pre-poll alliances. We've already made those alliances. The NDA government will come to power. Those who wish to join us are welcome to do so. So let's go across to our reporters, Akhilesh and Sunil, both following this story. Sunil, first to you, a bit of an anti-climax, really. One was expecting that 1 hour before the polls close, the campaigning ends in this whole election, the Prime Minister will actually hold his first press conference. But he just sat there at Amit Shah's press conference. In fact, it wasn't as if the journalists, the reporters, didn't make an attempt to get the PM to answer their questions. They asked him repeatedly. At one point, I think he said, "I'm a disciplined soldier. The party president is everything for me." Similarly, Amit Shah said, I'm in a position to answer this." What are the reactions we're getting also from the Congress there?
Well, the Congress, of course, calling it a damn squib, as you know, no less than Rahul Gandhi. And this is really a eyeball to eyeball. Sarah, never ever before in independent India have we seen two prime ministerial candidates holding press conferences on a simultaneous basis. Rahul Gandhi on the one hand at the Congress office and Narendra Modi at the BJP office. And Rahul Gandhi, of course, jumping the gun, saying, I would like a debate. I hope I have a question for the Prime Minister on Rafael. Why didn't he come for a debate? I was ready to go to even Racecourse Road, whatever the terms were there. So clearly, in independent India, as I said, this is the first time that, you know, election battles are being fought on television screens with the questions being asked from a Prime Ministerial candidate, Mr. Rahul Gandhi, who all along said, we'll wait for the 23rd for the people to speak about what the party's position is, who the Prime Minister will be, what will be the Congress party's position in terms of government formation and the rest of it. And of course, then talking about how he has learned through this entire campaign and really expected much better from the Prime Minister when he took oath as office and hoped that he would take India forward, but he failed in doing so. Clearly, the knives were out, and as the Congress was expecting him to take some questions, saying, finally, after 5 years, at the end of an entire election season, just minutes before that, he was ready to do a press conference. And then, of course, as we are well aware, the Congress has started tweeting out saying that this is completely a shame because the Prime Minister refused to answer. And of course, media people, as you're well aware, started saying Prime Minister's first press conference when it wasn't his first press conference.